Now, two more people were last night killed in renewed clashes along the Kisumu-Nandi border as several houses were torched in the troubled region. Muhoroni police have confirmed that the two, a widow and a middle-aged man, were shot with arrows at Darajambili and Songor areas, respectively. This brings to four the total number of people killed in the conflict, which is believed to have been triggered by land issues. Attempts by the National Cohesion and Integration Commission, led by its chairman, Francis Olekaparo, to hold a peace meeting in the region failed. Locals, led by their leaders, Muhoroni Member of Parliament Onyango Koyo and his Nyando counterpart Fredo Uta, declined to have the meeting at Songor area, the epicenter of skirmishes occasioned by cattle rustling. The two leaders engaged the commission in a bitter exchange of words and pointed out that the meeting served no purpose. They claimed that the border issue has been recurring, but the government has failed to find a lasting solution. Kaparo pleaded to be allowed to speak to the public who were affected by the skirmishes, but the leaders refused. Well, this is a situation that our Kisumu reporter Rashid Ronald has been closely following. Let's now link up with him to get more tips on what really is the situation down at the border of Kisumu and Nandi. Thank you for joining us on News Desk, Rashid. Kindly just give us a situation report on what really is happening there right now.
Yes, indeed, Akif, as you speak right now, I am at Owiro Farm, where we are actually expecting a public baraza to be led by officials from both Kisumu and Nandi counties. And as you speak right now, I've just seen some people who camped here from last night. They've been camping here because of what happened. We witnessed about seven houses which were torched around here. And it seems that the kills are spilling towards this area, because everything started at Songor Farm. But one thing I will also want us to clarify, because there's a lot of confusion about the total number of people who have been killed so far since the clashes began on Monday. There are people who are saying that two more people were killed today. But what we were able to confirm, we actually confirmed the man who was killed at Odio Wange village in Songor here. That one I'm quite sure, because we confirmed, we saw the body. But the body of that, the issue of the woman, I can really not confirm. But we made an effort to talk to the OCPD of Muhoroni, and he was like accusing the media for getting it wrong, telling us that we've gotten it wrong. We are reporting that there are two more people are killed. He says so far three people have been killed since Monday. The person was killed on Monday, then another one was killed on Tuesday, and the one who was killed last night, the one I spoke about, the one I saw at Odio Wange in Songor. And just to give you a picture of what is happening here at the border, I will clearly say there is a bit of tension around, and police officers from various places have been deployed here. They are doing some patrols here at the border. We have police officers from Kakamega, witness police officers from Vihiga, some of them coming all the way from Homa Bay. So the patrols are being done here by the police. Also, we can say there is a heavy presence of police officers. And in the morning, we witnessed women and children leaving their houses with their belongings, especially at Odio Wange in Songor, where that man was killed. Some schools have been closed as we speak right now. And as I said, police, his presence is very heavy here. And earlier on, we had a press briefing from the leadership of the Anglican churches from both Nandi and Kisumu. They had a press briefing with the media about 2 hours ago. They condemned these killings. They are saying they are calling upon police to come in and even use force so that they can be able to protect the lives of innocent Kenyans. They are saying that this issue is about cattle rustling, a few people, a few hooligans. And also they're asking politicians not to really incite people. They also condemned a case where yesterday leaders, MPs for Nyando and Muhoroni, who actually led the people in preventing Kaparo and team from addressing people here. And we've also went all the way to some border between the leadership in Nandi. We've spoken to some MCAs in the area. And both of them are actually calling for peace. So they're saying police should come in and arrest those people. They are terming them as hooligans. And also, I've managed to speak to the area MP, Tindret MP Paul Melly, who told me that he's on his way from Nairobi to this place. And he's going to be here by around 3. And he's
All right. Thank you very much, Rashid, for giving us that report.